God speaks if we would only take time to listen. And our world is turned upside down, topsy-turvy, by this unfolding mystery of the incarnation, God made flesh. If you would like to speak with someone about your faith journey this morning or about membership in this body of Christ, one of the pastors will be at the foot of the chancel steps this morning to speak with you. And now I invite you to stand as you are able to say what it is that we believe through a portion of the brief statement of faith as it is printed in the sidebar of your bulletin. What is it that we believe? In life and in death, we belong to God. Through the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit, we trust in the one triune God, the Holy One of Israel, whom alone we worship and serve. We trust in Jesus Christ, fully human, fully God. Jesus proclaimed the reign of God, preaching good news to the poor and release to the captives, teaching by word and deed, and blessing the children, healing the sick, and binding up the brokenhearted, eating with outcasts, forgiving sinners, and calling all to repent and believe the gospel. Unjustly condemned for blasphemy and sedition, Jesus was crucified, suffering the depths of human pain, and giving his life for the sins of the world. God raised this Jesus from the dead, vindicating his sinless life, breaking the power of sin and evil, and delivering us from death to eternal. With believers in every time and place, we rejoice that nothing in life or in death can separate us from the love of God in Christ Jesus our Lord. You may be seated. As we together offer the prayers of the people, you will note that there is a response in the prayers this morning. I will say, O God of love, and we will all respond, hear our prayer. Let us pray. Good and gracious God, we pray that you will grant us a glimpse of your glory so that we may rejoice in your presence coming to us in the coo of a newborn child. We remember at this time that you came to turn our world upside down with your unrelenting and unconditional love. You brought hope to those who have nothing to look forward to, peace to those who are full of anxious daily cares, joy to those who are experiencing the pains of loss. On this day of your love breaking through, we pray that you will come into our lives and turn us all again to you. O God of love, hear our prayer. Lord Jesus, we pray that you will prepare us for your coming into the world, that in these difficult, divisive times, you will drive away despair from our politics and division from our discourse. Revive your dreams of justice and restore our passion for what is right, good, and true. O God of love, hear our prayer. May your unending love motivate our care for our neighbors and for the wider community. Help us all to play a part in working to overcome the systems that drag so many into despair. O God of love, hear our prayer. God of presence, we pray that you would send us into the lives of those who have suffered loss and separation in this season, when that loss and separation can seem more acute. We especially pray for the Heidenreich family and any who have experienced disease, long illness, and the pains of death. Be with them in their grief and comfort them in their sorrow. O God of love, hear our prayer. Too often, O Christ, we have been silent and missed opportunities to share with others the message of love which you brought into the world. And we ask that you will give us all an unquestioning faith, the deep faith of Mary, and show us a new way to live so that, with your long-suffering kindness and with an awareness of your presence, we will follow you in thought and word and deed. O God of love, hear our prayer. Holy Christ child, as we seek to find rest from the pace of this often hectic season, give us eyes to see your face in the face of the stranger in our midst. Give us ears to hear your voice in the familiar voices that surround us. Give us hearts to feel the divine incarnational presence in the lives of all with whom we interact on this day. O God of love, hear our prayer. And teach us this day and every day to pray anew the prayer you taught all those who claim your name to pray, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts, as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver